Okay. What would you do if you were asked to factor a sum of two cubes? For instance, a cubed plus b cubed. Could you do it? Okay. First of all, note, a cubed plus b cubed is not a plus b cubed. Okay, why not? Well, let's just take some numbers to see if it's true. Let's take 2 cubed plus 5 cubed. The big question is that really just a 2 plus 7? I'm sorry, a 2 plus 5 cubed? Well, 2 cubed is 8, and 5 cubed is 125, and that's 133. 7 cubed. Well, 7 cubed is 7 times 7 times 7, and that's 343. So, if it's not going to work with those numbers, then it's certainly not going to be true. So, a cubed plus b cubed is simply not the same thing as just writing a plus b in parentheses cubed. If you want to know what the quantity a plus b cubed is, you really have to multiply a plus b times itself three times. So a plus b times a plus b times a plus b. Now, we know what a plus b times a plus b, that's the formula for a perfect square, a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, but then you'd have to multiply that by another a plus b. So you could do this using the box method, a squared 2ab b squared a and b, and I would get a cubed 2a squared b and a b squared and a squared b and a 2ab squared and a b cubed, and then I would add all these like terms on the diagonals, so that gives me a cubed. Now this is 2a squared b plus 1a squared b, that's a 3 a squared b, and this is a 3ab squared, and this one is a b cubed. So the answer to a cubed, I'm sorry, a plus b cubed, if you multiply it all out, is a cubed plus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared plus b cubed. So there's another reason why you definitely should be able to understand why a plus b cubed is just not a cubed plus b cubed. There's these other two things as your middle terms. Okay, I'm going to ask you to put this on pause and multiply a squared minus ab plus b squared times a plus b. You could use the box method like I just did or any method and see what you get. Okay, my work is shown here. I got a cubed plus b cubed. So lo and behold, you would never be able to figure this out on your own, but somebody did. A cubed plus b cubed actually factors to what I have at the top here, a squared minus ab plus b squared times a plus b, and it doesn't matter the order you write those in. Okay, so we have a formula for a cubed plus b cubed. It's the quantity a plus b times a squared minus ab plus b squared. Now, you cannot factor this larger trinomial over here in parentheses. This is not a perfect square. You can't factor it any further to a plus b quantity squared or a minus b quantity squared or anything else. When you factor a sum of two cubes, you're going to have one parentheses a plus b and the other parentheses a squared minus ab plus b squared. So let's do an example. Let's do x cubed plus 125. So it might be easier if you think of this as x cubed plus 5 cubed. All right, so then what do we do from here? I just pay attention to what's in each parentheses. I'm first going to write out the x plus 5. So in other words, the two terms with no cubes. So x plus 5. Now the next part's going to have three parts in it. It's going to be the first term squared, so that's x squared. If this was a plus, that's going to be a minus. That these two are going to be opposite signs. You'll see in a minute what I mean by that. And then x times 5. You multiply these two things together, whether you're looking in the parentheses here or over here. X times 5, which is 5x. And always the last one is a plus the 5 squared. You have to square that term. That's the answer, and you can't go any further unless there was like a common factor you could take out. All right, there's also a formula for the difference of two cubes, and you could verify this by multiplying this binomial by this trinomial, and you'll also get a cubed minus b cubed, similarly to how we did it for a cubed plus b cubed. And notice the difference here. When it's a cubed plus b cubed, there's an a plus b in the first parentheses, and when there's an a cubed minus b cubed, there's an a minus b in the first parentheses. So if the first parentheses has a plus, in the next parentheses, there's a minus for the next sign. If the first parentheses is a minus, in the fir I'm sorry, if the problem is a minus, then in the first parentheses is a minus and a plus goes afterwards. So it either goes plus minus or it goes minus plus. The last term is always plus. So this is a formula, and I think of it as looking really close to a perfect square over here, but it's not. It doesn't have the 2ab. Remember, it's even if you have a perfect square trinomial. This is just a times b. So here are the two formulas. So how are you going to factor 27y cubed minus 8? Now, if you want, you can write this first as 3y cubed minus 2 cubed. I usually do that part in my head and just write the 3 minus y minus 2 in the first parentheses. And then I pay attention to the 3y and the minus 2 as I go along. So I'm going to take the first term and square it. 3y times 3y is 9y squared. Now, this had a minus sign in the first parentheses, so it changes signs in here for the middle term. And you only multiply 3y times 2. It's not 2 times 3y times 2. It's just the 3y times the 2. 6y plus the last term squared. 2 times 2 is 4. And you look and see, can you factor any further? No. The only thing you might be able to do if you forgot in the original problem was to take out a common factor. Something like that might happen, but you cannot factor this as a perfect square. It's not a perfect square. So that is the answer. Okay, let's summarize a little if you have the summed difference of two terms. First of all, you always look for a common factor, but then we have the difference of two squares, which factors to a plus b times a minus b. If you have a squared plus b squared, the sum of two squares, it cannot be factored. A cubed plus b cubed has this factorization, a plus b times a squared minus ab plus b squared, and the difference of cubes is similar except the signs are different in a couple of places. So what about if you had this problem? Factor 2x to the seventh minus 2x. So it's two terms. The first thing in every factoring problem to see is if there is a common factor, and in this case, 2x is the common factor. So I take that out. And the factor I have left is x to the sixth minus 1. Now we look at that. Is that a difference of two squares or the difference of two cubes or the sum of two cubes? And in this case, it's the difference of two squares and the difference of two cubes. Anytime it's both, for instance, x squared to the third power is x to the sixth, and x cubed squared is also x to the sixth. So the top one, it shows that it's a perfect cubed, and the bottom one shows it's a perfect squared. If you have a choice, do it as the difference of two squares first. All right, so what I need to do is factor this as the difference of two squares, which is x cubed plus 1 times x cubed minus 1. If you don't do this, you'll get stuck and not be able to factor completely. All right. So we've gotten this far. Now we look again at what's in parentheses. I have a sum of two cubes and a difference of two cubes, so we need to factor each of those. Well, x cubed plus 1 is going to be x plus 1, times x squared minus x plus 1 using our new formula. And x cubed minus 1 is going to be x minus 1 times x squared plus x plus 1. Now you look at all the factors and see if you could factor further. X plus 1 can't go any further. X squared minus x plus 1 cannot go any further. That is not a perfect square. And the same thing for the next two factors. So this is your final factorization. That's pretty much putting it all together using our new formulas.